Hi, I'm Emanuele Morlini, I'm from RCF R&D department, and today I'm here for presenting you TTL 11A and M, that are two modules that are the part of a TTL 11 system that we consider as a really powerful tool for solving a problem in places in which you've got acoustical problems. And it's a sound system that is used for live performances. It's a sound column, as you can see, that has the steerable array technology. So if you wanted to use it in a place in which the room acoustic it is not ideal, for example in a conference room or in a theater or any indoor places, you've got the opportunity to adjust the coverage of the system and focus its emission only in the area in which you want the sound really reproduced. So this is not a standard sound column, because the feature that it has are for the use in the professional field, and has been designed as a sound reinforcement also for live performances, because as you can see, it has an hardware that permits an easy installation even for mobile installation, so also for rental companies. And it features four times compression drivers of 1.5 inch throat diameter and 2.5 inch voice coil. All of them are driven by a separate digital power amplifier. We have again in the satellite, so in the upper box, three 8 inch mid-ranges with a 2.5 inch voice coil. And in the second module, that is the complementary module of the first one, that is for the reproduction of the mid-low section, feature four 8-inch woofers. All of them again are driven by separate amplifiers. So the total number of amplifiers that are on board, all of them again are digital, and all transducers are neodymium in order to give you the possibility of an easy transportation because of the lightweight. I was saying that the total number of the amplifier, it is 7. So having a DSP on board, that is a 96 kHz 24-bit floating point of the last generation, you've got the possibility to adjust all the different settings of this amplifier in order to change the tilt angle of the speaker from 0 to minus 10. So you've got the possibility of a virtual changing of the coverage, so the tilt angle of the speakers, without moving anything from the hardware of the speaker itself. The second very useful feature that it has, you've got also the possibility to change the beam of the speaker. And in this way you got the possibility with two options, with an optional Arduino controller, so with a remote software, or using the buttons on the back that I'm going to show you later, you got the possibility to change also the coverage angle of the speaker itself. Here we got also its complementary sub that feature two times 15 inch woofers that are in direct radiation with an incredible power of 3400 watts. Even this sub is active, and it is possible to connect it with the RDNet, so it is possible to remote control all the adjustment, all the frequency cuts that can be set also by pressing the button that we got on the rear panel of the sub itself. Regarding the rear panel on which we have all the controls of the amplifiers and DSPs, as you can see, we got two interfaces. One that is the interface for the connection of the RDNet that is based on the RJ45 connector with a Cat5 cable that permits with the Control 8 unit and its dedicated software to remote all the adjustment and to monitor all the inner parameter of the amplifier on your PC. On the other hand, we have the opportunity to change all the preset of the speaker itself by using that interface that consists on these buttons and this potentiometer. We got two options. We got the possibility to change the preset of the wall mounting by pressing this button that is for recalling a preset that is in order to compensate the coupling of the speaker itself from the wall, from the nearest wall. And we got also the possibility to change by pressing the button that we got in correspondence of this potentiometer to change the height of the speaker, the height that means the installation height of the speaker itself. You got the possibility to, by pressing again this button in which we will have this LED that is going to be lighted on, we got the possibility to adjust the throw. So it means that we got the possibility to set the coverage in relation of the tilt angle of the speaker and the beaming. So in other words, in order to make the installation easier for the end user, we got different coverages that depends on throw. So we automatically adjust the beaming and the tilt angle in relation of the height of the speaker itself with our algorithm in order to have a real control on the pattern of the speaker. And the third option, it is the possibility to also to adjust the delay of the speaker itself. And the lowest section, so the TTL 11AB section, is controlled with an Ethernet cable. So on the lowest section we got no DSP, but everything it is managed from the top speaker. So the only thing that we got to do for controlling all the parameter of the low section, it is just to plug the Ethernet connection from the top to the bottom, and that's all.